Wind load analysis is a key aspect of structural engineering. It involves calculating the forces that the wind exerts on the structure. This lecture demonstrates it for a canopy attached to a building. Attached canopies are often used at the entrance of buildings for both aesthetic appeal and functional protection against the elements. Their design is predominantly governed by wind and snow loads. In this lecture, we exclude snow load and focus exclusively on wind load, which can exert significant forces on the structural elements of the system and its connections to the building. We show how to determine the effect of wind load on a cantilever canopy attached to a low-rise building. We focus on the basic methodology and calculations needed to determine the wind load applied to the canopy for its analysis and design. In this process, we utilize the American Society of Civil Engineers minimum design load provisions given in ASCE 722. The canopy measures 20 feet in width and 10 feet in depth. It is attached to the building's wall at a height of 12 feet above the ground. The height of the building is 30 feet. The building is located on flat terrain in a suburb of Denver, Colorado. Knowing the site's location, we can use the online ASCE hazard tool to retrieve the elevation and the basic wind speed for the building. The site has an elevation of 5,387 feet above sea level. The basic wind speed is 107 miles per hour. This wind speed is for structures in risk category 2, as defined by the ASCE standard, which includes most types of city buildings. Here is the summary of what we know so far. The pertinent dimensions of the canopy and relevant distances. We know the building is on flat terrain. We also know the ground elevation and the basic wind speed. Our objective is to determine the distributed load produced by wind that the canopy must be able to withstand. The ASCE standard categorizes risk levels for structural design based on a building's occupancy and function. There are four risk categories. Category 1 refers to structures that pose a low hazard to human life in the event of failure, such as some agricultural facilities. At the other end of the spectrum, Category 4 includes structures whose failure would inhibit essential community services necessary for emergencies. Examples include hospitals and fire stations. Category 3 includes structures that house many people in one place, such as schools and theaters. Structures that don't belong to Category 1, 3, or 4 are classified under Category 2, which includes most residential, commercial, and industrial buildings. The basic wind speed used for designing a structure is determined by its risk category. Since our canopy is part of a commercial building, we have chosen Category 2, resulting in a basic wind speed of 107 miles per hour. As a Category 1 structure, the basic wind speed would be 101 miles per hour. As a Category 3 structure, we would use a basic wind speed of 114 miles per hour. If the canopy were in Category 4, the basic wind speed would be 117 miles per hour. These differences in basic wind speed affect the design outcome in measurable ways. For example, the wind load applied to a structure in risk Category 4 is about 35% higher than if placed in risk Category 1. The pressure that wind exerts on the canopy can be determined using this equation. This pressure can be positive, meaning it is directed toward the surface of the canopy, or it can be negative, indicating that it is pulling away from the canopy's surface. The terms in the equation are Q sub H, wind velocity pressure, K sub D, wind directionality factor, and GC sub P, net pressure coefficients for attached canopies. Let's examine each of these terms in detail. The wind directionality factor is a numerical adjustment that we use to account for the reduced likelihood that the strongest wind forces will always strike a structure from the most critical direction. Consider a round, symmetrical water tank. It presents the same profile to the wind from any direction. This uniformity ensures that the wind force acting on the structure is consistent regardless of the wind direction. Because of this, the wind directionality factor for the tank is 1. In contrast, for a typical building, we use a reduced wind directionality factor to account for the lower probability that wind will consistently strike from the most critical direction. ASCE Table 26.61 assigns a value of 0.85 for the wind directionality factor for buildings. The wind velocity pressure can be found in ASCE equation 26.101. The equation is defined in terms of velocity pressure exposure coefficient, topographical factor, ground elevation factor, and the basic wind speed, which we determine to be 107 miles per hour. The velocity pressure exposure coefficient is a factor used to account for variations in wind speed due to differences in terrain and height above ground level. To determine this coefficient, ASCE categorizes three types of environments. These are called exposure categories. We have categories B, C, and D. Category B is for areas with lots of buildings, houses, and trees, like cities and suburbs. These buildings and trees act as barriers that slow down the wind, making it less strong near the ground. This category applies to places where many closely spaced structures reduce the wind's impact on any single building. Category D is for areas near large bodies of water, like oceans or big lakes, where there are no barriers to slow down the wind. In these places, the wind can blow freely and get very strong because there are no buildings, trees, or other obstacles in the way. This category applies to locations right at the shoreline with open water extending at least 5,000 feet. Category C is for areas with some open spaces and scattered buildings or trees, like farmland or countryside. There are enough open areas for the wind to pick up speed, but the scattered structures still provide some obstacles that slow it down a bit. This category applies to places that are more open than cities but not completely unobstructed like shorelines. In the case of our canopy, we need to choose exposure category B, since the building is located in a suburban area with other buildings and obstacles nearby. Knowing the exposure category, we can find K sub Z from ASCE Table 26.101. This table shows the velocity exposure coefficient based on height and exposure category. For category B at 30 feet, K sub Z is 0.7. Note that we calculated the exposure coefficient, K sub Z, at the building's height. At a height of 30 feet. Not at the height of the canopy. We did so because equation 30.91 requires the velocity pressure to be determined at the mean height of the roof of the building. Next, let's explain how to determine the topographical factor in the wind velocity pressure equation. Wind speed increases as it moves up a hill, significantly increasing wind pressure on nearby structures. ASCE includes a topographical coefficient, labeled K sub ZT, in the wind pressure equation to account for this increased pressure. The coefficient is calculated using this equation. It uses three multipliers, K1, K2, and K3. They range between 0 and 1. Therefore, KZT is always greater than or equal to 1. When a building is near a hill, ridge, or escarpment, the coefficient is greater than 1. On flat terrain, it equals 1. Since our building is on flat terrain, we can set the topographical coefficient to 1. In a future lecture, we will investigate a scenario where the structure is situated on a hill, leading to a topographical coefficient greater than 1. Next, we determine the ground elevation factor, KE. As elevation increases, air density decreases, resulting in a decrease in wind pressure on structures. ASCE incorporates the ground elevation factor in the wind pressure equation to account for this reduced wind pressure at high elevations. ASCE Table 26.91 lists the ground elevation factors for various elevations above sea level. According to the ASCE hazard tool, the elevation of our building is 5,387 feet above sea level. From Table 26.91, the ground elevation factor is 0.83 at 5,000 feet and 0.8 at 6,000 feet. By interpolation, we can determine K sub E for the elevation of 5,387 feet. It equals 0.82. Substituting these coefficients in this equation, we get. So, we have determined Q sub H and K sub D. Next, we need to determine the net pressure coefficients for the canopy. Wind could push down on the top surface of the canopy, producing a positive pressure on that surface. A suction pressure could also be produced by wind on the top surface of the canopy. We refer to this as a negative pressure. Wind can also create positive and negative pressures on the canopy's bottom surface. The ASCE provisions provide a set of coefficients to account for both positive and negative pressures when designing various components of canopies. For designing the structural skeleton of a canopy, ASCE recommends using the net effect of positive and negative pressures. This means that we need to consider two cases. Case 1, when the net pressure acting on the canopy's skeleton is positive. And, case 2, when the net pressure is negative. The net positive and negative pressure coefficients for canopies attached to buildings less than 60 feet high are provided in Figure 30.91b. In our case, H sub C is 12 feet, and H sub E is 30 feet. The ratio of HC to HE is 0.4, and the area of the canopy is 200 square feet. We can use this graph to determine the positive and negative net pressure coefficients based on the area of the canopy and the HC to HE ratio. To determine the positive coefficient, we use this line. For an area of 200 square feet, we get a positive coefficient of approximately 0.65. To determine the negative coefficient, since our HC to HE ratio is 0.4, we need to use this line. For an area of 200 square feet, we can use a coefficient of negative 0.5. To determine the design wind pressure, we use two net pressure coefficients, one for the negative net pressure and one for the positive net pressure. Using the negative coefficient of 0.5, we obtain a design wind pressure of 7.15 pounds per square foot. Using the positive coefficient of 0.65, we obtain a design wind pressure of 9.3 pounds per square foot. The top surface of the canopy rests on 4 cantilever beams. The largest tributary area of the top surface, directly supported by a beam, has a width of 6.67 feet. The wind pressure for this area is either positive 9.3 pounds per square foot or negative 7.15 pounds per square foot. Multiplying the design wind pressure by 6.67, we get the design wind load for the beam. Each beam is to be designed for two load cases. a downward distributed load of 62 pounds per foot, and an upward distributed load of 47.7 pounds per foot. In this lecture, we ignored the snow load. However, in practice, both wind and snow loads must be considered when designing the system.